Good morning, students. Today we are going to recap the previous video you have learned that if we have two lines in a plane, suppose L and N are two lines in a plane, they may be intersecting line, parallel line, or coincident line. If they are intersecting line, they come under unique solution and consistent. If they are parallel lines, comes under inconsistent equation and has no solution. If they are coincident line, come under consistent and they have infinite number of solution. So without drawing graph, we can find that the equation, the given pair of equation is consistent or inconsistent. Inconsistent. If they are consistent, then they have unique solution or infinite solution, or they are inconsistent, then they have no solution. So if a1 a2 are the coefficient of x in both the pair of equation, b1 and b2 are the coefficient of y, c1 and c2 are constant. So if a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, has unique solution. If a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2 has infinite solution, and if a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 but not equal to c1 by c2 has no solution. Solution of the equation. Solution of the equation. See, solution means, what do you mean by solution of the equation? Solution of the equation is the value of the variable which satisfies the equation. The value of the variable which satisfies the equation is called solution of the equation. So x minus up here, x minus y equal to 3. This is a linear equation in two variables. That's why it has infinite number of solutions. But if you take these two equations simultaneously, that is called simultaneous system of linear equation, x minus y equal to 3 and 2x plus 3y equal to 5, then it may be an intersecting line, a parallel line, or a coincident line. So by seeing the ratio of the coefficient, a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2, after comparing the coefficients, we can only say that the equation has infinite solution and no solution or unique solution. So the solution of the equation, the main thing is the solution of the equation is the value of the variable which makes the equation, which satisfies the equation. Methods to find the solution of the pair of equation. So we can find the number of solution by this method. So first method is substitution method, second one is elimination method, and third one is cross multiplication. This is applicable for only unique solution. You can find only unique solution by using these three methods: substitution method, elimination method, and cross multiplication. So now you first see the substitution method. First method is substitution method. See the substitution method. So substitution method, understand the method. So when, मान लीजिए आपके क्लास में अगर कोई टीचर नहीं आते हैं, तो आप क्या करते हैं? आप ऑफिस जाके पहले डायरी में चेक करते हैं कि उस टीचर के बदले कोई है या नहीं. So that is substitution diary. So here, there you see the in place of your teacher, which one is appointed. So by this facility, by substitution method is that which is the substitute value of another variable. So this is equation 1 and equation 2. From equation 1, we can write the substitute value of x as 3 plus y. Here x minus y equal to 3, we can substitute in place of x which value? 3 plus y. Substituting these values in the second equation, 2x plus 3y equal to 5. place of x, what we have to substitute? 3 plus y. 3 plus y plus 3y equal to 5. Now solve the equation. 6 plus 2y plus 3y equal to 5. 5y equals to 5 minus 6. Y equals to minus 1 by 5. So this is the value for y. Y equals to minus 1 by 5. Now again you substitute the value of y in x. X equal to, now we get the value of x by substituting the value of y. X equal to 3 plus y. 3 plus y in place of y. So put minus 1 by 5. Take LCM, 15 minus 1, 14 by 5. So this is the solution of the equation. It is applicable for only unique solution. So now compare. Compare A1 by A2. Here A1 is x, coefficient of x 1. A2, coefficient of x in second equation 2. A1, A2. B1, B2. B1 minus 1 and B2 3. So now see B1 by B2, A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. A1 by A2, A1 by A2 is 1 by 2 and B1 by B2 is minus 1 by 3, which is not equal to each other. That's why it has unique solution, and the solution of the equation is that the value of x is 14 by 5 and the value of y is minus 1 by 5. If you substitute these two values in these two equations, it satisfies the equation. That's why it is called solution of the equation. So this is the first method, substitution method. Now we will go for second method, elimination method. As the name shows, elimination. Elimination means you have to eliminate something. So here we have two equations, x minus y equal to 3 and 2x plus 3y equal to 5. Then we have to eliminate either x or y according to your choice. You can eliminate either x or y. So what you want to eliminate, multiply the coefficient of first equation to another second equation and the coefficient of that variable by the first equation. So here x minus y equal to 3, 2x plus 3y equal to 5. I want to eliminate x. So I want to eliminate x, that's why the coefficient of x here is 1. First equation the coefficient of x is 1. I multiply 1 by second equation. And the coefficient of x in second equation is 2. I multiply by 2. I multiply first equation by 2. So here we get, after solving we get 2x minus 3y equal to 6 and x plus 3y equal to 5. Now after subtracting, so while you subtract, you change the sign. So 2x plus 2x, then you change sign by minus, plus 3y change it by minus, plus 5 change it by minus. So plus minus 0, minus 2y minus 3y, minus 5y. Do you leave this sign plus? 6 minus 5, 6 minus 5, forget this plus sign. Plus sign. 6 minus 5, 1. So y equals to minus 5, 1 by 5. Now you substitute this value either in equation 1 or equation 2. So after substituting the value of y in first equation, x equal to 3 plus y, x equal to 3 plus, in place of y, we put minus 1 by 5 there.